Right, welcome back to the channel. So, 1 year since buying the SV650, and yeah, we're just gonna go basically see how it's doing, my thoughts on it, and how it's kept for the last year. So, quick little walk around, and then we'll crack on with the main part of the video. So, wheels there, you've got 17 inch wheels. I apologise, mine are a little bit dirty. The weather's pretty trash at the moment, but yeah, 290mm. Disc brakes, LCD screen there on the front. Excuse my quad lock. Nice little easy start push button. Yeah, so steel frame. Obviously comes in multiple colours. I've got the red and white there. You can get all sorts of colours. I believe these are selling for $7,199 if you go onto the Suzuki website. I bought this one with about 1,000 miles on it. And yeah, it adds. I think it knocks off about $3,000. I got it for $5,000 in the end, so yeah, saved a couple of grand on it for the sake of 1,000 miles, and it all had the first few services done and everything. So, right, off we go. It's a bit wet today, so I probably won't be able to throw it around as much as I usually do, just to get my excuses in now. But also, I apologise if the audio on this is different to usual. And it's poorer. I have got new gear, new helmet, and I've thrown me a mic in here, but I don't know how good it's going to be, so just bear with it. We'll see. Right, anyway, here we go. So handling, I've never had any dramas with this. This thing loves a corner. Like I said, it is wet, so I don't want to go too over the top with this, but yeah, you can really throw this thing around corners. It'll just eat them up. You can lean it over quite a fair amount. I think it's one of the heavier sort of 600 entry level bikes. That's what I forgot to mention on the walk around. This does have a 645cc engine, I believe it is. But yeah, I think this is one of the heavier entry level sort of 600 bikes you can get, but I think it plays to its advantage. It just feels a lot more planted when you're going to sling it around a corner. Yeah, I like it. The cornering on it is pretty delightful. There's some pretty twisty roads around here. I cross around every day and I have a fair bit of fun on them, so. We'll head over to a little car park and we'll go through a bit of slow manoeuvring just to see how it keeps, here comes a rainlet, just to see how it holds up with slow manoeuvring as opposed to the fast manoeuvres that you can see here, but yeah. But until then, we'll keep on going. So I'm quite a tall rider. I think I'm about 190 centimetres, about 6'3". And this has got a relatively low seat profile. However, obviously you can bang after aftermarket, like seat covers and stuff there, just to raise it an inch or so. But even at 6'3", I don't find it a disadvantage. My legs are slightly cramped. Cramped's probably a strong word. I mean, I've rode this down from mine to Cheddar Gorge and back again all in the same day. That was probably about 10 hours worth of riding. And it wasn't that bad at all. It was nice and comfy. Just like the standard seat it comes with, just keeps you comfy anyway. But yeah, the legroom was all right, even as a tall rider that I am. But yeah, it's not too bad. Oh, the rain's really coming in now, so I'll try and keep the cameras clear. Can't make any promises. Good old British weather, eh? Yeah, so as I briefly touched on at the start there, disc brakes front and rear, they do the job. I wouldn't say they're anything special, but I've done a couple of emergency stops and through probably my own fault, then a couple of just other people being idiots, but yeah, they've brought me to a pretty swift close, which has been good. Suspension, I believe I read it's got about a 5-inch travel, so when you do hammer that front brake, your forks really let you know about it. You will dip quite a lot, but again, as I said earlier, some of the roads around here are pretty questionable, especially when I'm on my way to work around the sort of like green lane-y type terrain up there. I never take this green lane in, but it feels like it up there. Yeah, it's the suspension holds its own up against that. I think there's some videos I put out before, quite near of me starting out this channel, and there's a road that looks like there's a song, that just craters everywhere. But yeah, it's. Yeah, it does its job up here, but I bought this for commuting to and from work, so I live half an hour away, but there's just roadworks everywhere. And it was taking me over an hour to get in my car, to get to work, so I was like, right, sorry, we'll buy this, because it's quite a decent little commuter. And yeah, I've just sort of fallen in love with it. It's a really, really decent little bike. Really good. The fuel consumption is pretty good. So I've literally just filled it up there before starting this video. About 15 quid. Bearing in mind I was almost out because I've been lazy and didn't fill it up after my last ride. But with that on, I'm getting, I'd say, over 150 miles. I've never tested the actual range of this bike. I've never filled it up at a reset mechanic, because usually I'd like to fill it up way, way, way before going empty. It's just how I am. One day I might test the range on it, but I don't think it'll be anytime soon. So yeah, but just believe me when I say you're getting about 150 miles, and that's not necessarily sensible driving. Like sometimes I'll have blips on the way to work where I'll just send it if no one's on the dual carriageway. Sometimes I will drive sensible, so that's about an average we're getting at there. But you could just throw this ring nice and slowly around car parks all day if you really wanted to. Loads of control. Nice tight cornering on it as well. It's good. Good at slow manoeuvres. I usually hate U-turns if I'm honest. But with this, I don't actually mind them. I've banged in a few. When I first started, I hated them. With the 125 I was on, the YBR Custom, that thing turns like a tank. But yeah, this is quite good. I would have done more there, however, you've seen there, it's pretty busy, which surprises me because it's rainy, and I would have thought everyone wouldn't be out walking their dogs today, but there we go. Right, we'll head up here, because this is a quiet little road, and we'll just do an acceleration test. See what the 0-60 is on this thing. Again, it's not going to be punching the best times ever because it's wet. This road's usually quite leafy as well, and I don't want to be binning it whilst making a video with all my new gear on, the first time out of it, and I'll end up in the woodblock over there somewhere because I've binned it too much. So yeah, I'm not going to be fully aggressive with it, but I'll give you a little rough idea of the acceleration of the 60 from a static start. So from static, I'll try and get some sort of timer up on this on the video, but like I said, it's not going to be quick because the weather's shit, but here we go. Right, we'll just go give a little blast out. There's a dual carriageway nearby that we can take it on, as long as it's not too busy. Although judging by this, it's going to be busy. Yeah, we're taking the dual carriageway, put it up round and round about and come back. Just check the, what's that? Yeah, we'll check the acceleration on the move. With top speeds of this thing, I've never looked into it. I don't buy bikes based on their top speed because, to be honest, you're never ever going to use that in the UK anyway. There's too many speed cameras, there's too many cops, we're the most watched country in the world, so I don't buy bikes for their top speed because I know I'm never ever going to get to that. I have ridden this thing obviously over speed limits, but in controlled environments, etc. However, I've never gone over about 110. One, because you scared the shit out of me. Yeah, so I just never had the environment to really go that fast. Bear in mind though, this thing is a naked, so when you're on the dual carriageways and motorways and such, picking up your speeds over 70, you know about it. We'll drop it down, try and get to about 40 without holding any traffic up. Now we're clear. Good. Yeah, there we go. Let us fucking check the nice and quick on the 70. It's not, like I said, it's not a slow bike for what it is. For an entry level 645cc naked, essentially a commuter bike, it holds its own. It says about this bike. I completely forgot I was recording that, just because I was enjoying just hammering that little straight there. And that, I'm not saying that for the video, I genuinely completely zoned out there, forgot I was recording, forgot I was even doing this video, and I was just enjoying being on this bike. And like I said, I'm not making it up, that is 100% what just happened. But yeah. Would I recommend this for beginners? Absolutely, I would. I did my direct access on an SV650, which funnily enough is why I own one. I just found it so user friendly. Like I said, everything I've covered so far, it's just the perfect bike for beginners. If you want to jump straight into the 600s, SV650 is the one. Like, I remember picking it up, like the first day I picked up at a garage, and bearing in mind, it had been a couple of months since passing my test to jumping back on one at the garage. And it just felt so natural. They're just such an easy bike to ride. There's nothing hard about them at all. Like, I've never thought, oh, this needs changing. If I broke this one today, I would get straight on to Auto Trader or whatever, and I'd be looking for another SV650, a second-hand one, because it's just, I think it's just unbeatable for commuting. Like, I don't think I could get a bike to travel about on, and I can have fun on it. I'll go to all the rides with the boys and stuff. So yeah, it's just an all-round, comfortable, good bike. Little V-twin engine, 645cc. Puts up a fight against the big bikes when you want it to. It's a good all-rounder. Ah, something I did fail to mention. It wasn't really a selling point for me. It was for the missus though. She had never been on the back of a bike previous to being with me, or previous to me doing my license, should I say. I was looking at a Trident for a little bit, and she looked at one and she was instantly put off by the tiny little pillion seat. However, the seat on this SV650, if you're looking at taking your missus out, or your boyfriend, or whoever, your partner, the pillion seat on these things, it's pretty big. I've not seen one equal to or bigger or equal to than the one I've got on this. It's a big boy. You could definitely cart your missus about all day on that. She says it's relatively comfortable, but I probably would put a gel seat cover on there just to make it a little bit more comfortable for future. However, she rides now, so there's no point. But yeah, the pillion seat, big, definitely big. I'll leave it there for today. If you'd be so kind, drop a like, drop a comment, subscribe if you haven't, and the usual, ride safe, stay upright, and stay low, move fast. Catch you in the next one.